therefore, which of these is valid and which of these is invalid? Can you tell? Y'all can't tell between these two which one's valid and which one's invalid?
Only if I calculate out a truth table.
Okay. What if I say, if this thing is a cat, then this thing is a mammal. This thing is a mammal, therefore it's a cat. Is that valid or invalid?
Invalid.
Clearly that's bad reasoning, right? If it's a cat, then it's a mammal. It's not a mammal, therefore it's not a cat. Okay, so we know ahead of time that this one should be valid and this one should be invalid, okay? So the principle, and some of you may have started to discover this, right? When you're calculating these truth values, what is the only thing you're looking for? What is the only thing you care about? Whether or not there's a counterexample. So the question of answering validity or invalidity is to say, is there a counterexample? If the answer is yes, then you know it's what?
Invalid.
If the answer is no, you know it's what? Good. So now ask yourself, can I construct, if you're asking about whether or not there's a counterexample, ask yourself, can I make one? Can I construct one? Okay? So let's look at this. So what does a counterexample look like? Well, it's a place where the conclusion is false and the premises are all what?
True.
So let's assume that that conclusion is false. And let's see if we can consistently make those true, okay? If P is false and Q is true, I know what they are, right? Because assuming that that's true and that's false, it forces me to answer the question in this way. False true with a horseshoe is what?
True.
So we're good to go. Counterexample is when P is what and Q is what?
False true.
Is false and Q is true. Let's see if we can do the same thing here. So I'm going to make the not P false, because that's my conclusion, and I'm going to make the other ones true. If not P is false, what does that force P to be?
True. True.
If not Q is true, what does that force Q to be? So now I'm forced to write Q false and P what?
True.
True false with a horseshoe is what?
True. Oh, it's a horseshoe.
Right, I literally cannot make a counterexample. Trying to do so leads to a contradiction. The contradiction of simultaneously having to say that horseshoe is true and false. So because assuming that there's a counterexample and trying to construct one leads to a contradiction, the conclusion is that there is no counterexample. It's impossible to make one. I tried to do it and I ended up in a contradiction. So therefore, I know that there is no counterexample, and therefore I know that this is valid. So let's take a longer one from the book, right? Like,
I'm recording all this, by the way.
So like, pick one of those ones that's like a 16-line truth table.
I said M.
Well,
that's
M. D. Now, some of these are going to be more complicated than others, right? Because what you're looking for ultimately is a forcing method, right? You want to be forced to make certain assumptions. So we're looking at D, P or Q, horseshoe, not R and S, not R and P, horseshoe, not S, not P. Or Q or S.
Yeah. Told y'all. I think I picked it good.
Did I write this down correctly? You can always double check.
You got my paper.
And the conclusion is S or P.
Horseshoe.
Horseshoe.
Not.
Not. U and R. Okay? So the same thing, right? I want to make my conclusion what? And I want all my premises to be what?
True.
So I'm just going to go and assume that this is possible to do and see if I can do it without a contradiction.
So you just work each one backwards and try to see if you can make them all true and make that one false?
Mm-hmm. Without a contradiction.
Right. Go.
Sick.
Well, I'm not really working backwards. I mean...
You put the answer first.
I mean, I'm assuming that there's a contradiction and trying to construct it and find it. If I can do that, then I have the counterexample and it's invalid. If I cannot do that consistently, then it's valid. So yeah.
I think you're missing P by conditional, not R and D.
We're doing D. I'm doing D.
Yeah, I
think that's 2D.
Sorry, 2D.
Oh, okay.
Everybody's on the same page?
All right, yeah, now we're good.
Okay, good. So if I want to make this horseshoe false, what do I have to put the left side as? And what do I have to put the right side as? There's only one way to make a horseshoe false.
False, true.
True, false.
True, false.
So S and P are both false?
So this is true, and then this is false. The negation is false. If the negation is false, what's the and?
True.
What's the only way to make an and true?
Q and R both true.
Good. Now do you see how we're starting to solve what the atoms have to be? That's what you want, right? So I know that Q has to be true, and I know R has to be true. That's what I want, right? Here, it's ambiguous, right? Because there's a bunch of ways to make an or true, right? So I might have to go down different paths. Let's wait and see, right? Let's fill in some of the stuff over here with the information that I have so far, okay?
R is true.
Q is, so everywhere that Q is, I'm going to put true, and everywhere R is, I'm going to put true, right?
Mm-hmm.
R is true, Q is true. Okay, so far, this isn't giving us much information, right? Because a horseshoe can be true a bunch of different ways, and ors can be true a bunch of different ways, right? So what are the three possible ways, right? Well, this could be true because S and P are both true, because S is true and P is false, or this, right? Those are the three possibilities,
mm-hmm.
right? So I think we're going to have to explore all of those.
Prove.
Right? I said it involves more thinking, but at least you don't have to do 32 lines worth of truth table, right? So let's take this possibility, right? So what did I say? S and P are both true. So if S is true and P is true, then that or is true and this or is true. P is true, S is true, which means not S is false. True and true is true, and that's false. So are we good to go there?
I can't tell what.
No.
Yeah, I can't tell where your levels are at anymore.
Huh?
It's not one of the premises is false.
Which premise is false?
No, false if then false.
Okay.
The not R and P.
Practice time.
Yeah,
false.
Sorry. Okay.
So what I'm doing is like I'm trying to. There's no good way of doing this, right? So I know. So take this top line. That stuff I know has to be the case. Okay. Now we have possibility A, B, and C. So I'm doing those on different levels. Right. So first I'm taking possibility A that S and P are true, and everything else up here is as is. So that's why I'm writing it on this next level. So hopefully it matches up, right? If S is true and P is true, P being true and Q being true, what's the or?
True.
So that or being true and that S being true, what's this or?
True.
Okay, so we're good to go there.
Mm-hmm.
Right? No contradiction. Same thing here.
Well, but
it's false.
Oh, wait a minute. Okay.
Uh-oh.
So, yeah, so if P is
still,
true and S is
true,
true, that's true, this becomes false. False true with an or is still true.
Yeah,
so
true.
There's no contradiction so far, right? Let's do the same thing here. So P is true, S is true. So if S is true, what's not S?
False.
So now we have a false right-hand side of a horseshoe. Now we're in danger territory. If that left-hand side of that horseshoe is true, we can't consistently make that true.
So it's
not the option. Well, hold on. So, all right, so R is true and P is true. What's the and?
True.
Well, the negation makes it false. So false, false with the horseshoe is true.
Boom.
Right? You're so we're still good to go there. And S is true. We're assuming S and P are true. Okay, S is true and P is true. True, true with an OR is what?
True.
And true, true with an AND is what?
True.
Negated and becomes false. Now you have true, false, right?
Yeah.
So I'm forced to make that both true and false at the same time, which is a contradiction. Okay? So look, here's what's tricky. Just because I couldn't make a counterexample on this row, does that mean it's valid?
No.
Why not?
The other.
You still have possibility B and C.
I still don't understand how it's true and false. Like
it's not. It's revealing a contradiction in our assumptions.
Oh, because you're trying to make it true. So what you're saying is it came out false, so it's not right.
So it can't be both at the same time.
I'm with you.
Right. So method or route A of making S true, P true, Q true, and R true isn't going to get you the counterexample. But that doesn't mean a counterexample doesn't exist. There are these other paths that we need to travel down. Right. So let's do the same thing again. This time we're going to say S is true and P is false, right? So true, false with an OR is what?
True.
True, and then negated, it becomes false. False, true with an OR is what?
True.
Same thing there, so far so good.
I'm gonna come up with a cleaner way to do this because this is starting to confuse me.
Because these are all the possible ways of making this OR true.
But so Q and R stays true.
Because they're forced to be what they are. Remember, you're looking for ways of forcing you into a decision. So what did I say? We're an S true and P false. Is that correct? So if S is true, what's not S?
False.
And if P is false and R is true, what's the and?
False.
And negated, that becomes true.
Yeah.
True false with a horseshoe is false. So that route doesn't lead to the contradiction. So now we have one route left. We have C. And if we can't consistently make the counterexample with C, then we know that there doesn't exist one because those are the only three paths that we had, right? Now again, with this, I mean, I didn't pre-plan this example. So with this example, it looks like it's longer than the long method, right? But I guarantee you, in general, this is gonna be a way shorter way of going about it. And it really gets you thinking, right? It really gets you thinking. You'll know it better if you do it like this. Okay, so S now is false and P is true. True, true with an OR is what?
True.
And that becomes false.
Yeah.
S being false, there's our contradiction that time.
It's valid.
So it's valid.
Sick.
Did you get valid when you did it the long way?
Nobody does.
Yeah, we didn't get that far.
Nobody's done it?
I'm not that ballsy. Try to do a truth table for all this.
So I know that this looks pretty complicated, but it ultimately isn't, right? Let's do another. I got 5 minutes.